football season can't come soon enough. The Utes kick off the 2013 season at Rice-Eccles Stadium against Utah State on Thursday, August 29th. Kickoff times for four games were announced this week by the Pac-12 Conference. The season opener with Utah State will start at 6 p.m. Mountain Time and will be the first college football game broadcast on Fox Sports 1, the new national sports network. Kickoff for the September 7th game with Weber State is at noon on Pac-12 networks. The Oregon State game will kick off at 8 p.m. on Fox Sports 1, and the Thursday night game against UCLA on October 3rd will kick off at 8 p.m. on Fox Sports 1. Start times for the rest of Utah's schedule will be made 12 or 6 days in advance. Alex Smith has made the move from San Francisco to Kansas City, and so far that transition has been a success. Alex participated in the team's OTAs and had a chance to work out with his new teammates and specifically his new receivers. Coaches have been impressed with his professionalism and quick learning of the playbook.
Full steam ahead, you know, I'm working as hard as I can, trying to push us as fast as we can go. You know, to a certain extent, trying to play catch up, you know, new offense. We got to catch up. We got to make up as much ground as fast as we can.
I guess one thing, I like the volume. I like how much they're throwing at us for an offseason. You know, I like how much the coaches are demanding of us. I think it's a great thing, you know, continue to push us. Expect a lot out of us, everybody. You know, I think it's going to make a difference come the fall.
Alex Smith isn't the only former Ute making the transition to Kansas City. Sean Smith signed with the Chiefs as a free agent, and he hopes to bring a big physical presence to the Chiefs' defensive backfield.
You know, as a defense, you want to be physical. I.e., just like the Ravens, you said, you know, you want to take the ball away. You know, you want to do all that. Communication, I mean, whatever you can do on the defensive side of the ball to be better, that's what we're striving for right now.
Former Ute Paul Kruger also adjusting to new surroundings in Cleveland. But before that, he has some business to attend to here in Utah. He sat down with Rod Zundel in the KSL studios to discuss the work he's doing with Chris Kruger Care Foundation, as well as the impact he hopes to have with the Cleveland Browns.
Paul Kruger, Super Bowl champ, former Ute. He was with the Ravens last year, got a ring, now making the move to Cleveland. He's in studio. Paul, good to see you again, my friend.
Thanks for having me.
All right, now you're here to talk about your Youth Leadership Academy Day, but before we get to that, of course, let's talk to the Super Bowl. Let's go back a few months. You beat the Niners in the Superdome, and man, has your life changed since that night when you picked up the ring.
Yeah, it's been a whirlwind of experience. You know, anything from the parade after, you know, in Baltimore was amazing. Just the support we got, it was... The whole city of Baltimore was literally on fire. I mean, you couldn't even see the streets. Army trucks took us through the city, and it was a lot of fun. And then moving on to free agency, making the transition to the Browns, and it's been history from there, just OTAs and all sorts of new things.
How is it now going from the best defense in the NFL, one of the best defenses in the league, now to the Browns defense, which still really hasn't had an identity the last few years?
Yeah, it's... You know, it's something I'm looking forward to because of the opportunities, you know, and we have a chance to really create, you know, a tradition and kind of a new start for this team. And so there's nothing more exciting for me than to be able to come in and help, you know, jumpstart that opportunity.
Now, you're going back to Baltimore this week, right, for a little special ceremony to get the old, old rings?
Yeah, get the jewelry. So I'm pretty excited. We get to go hang out in the stadium. And from what I've heard about 2000, they actually flew the rings down in helicopters, and you're able to try it on in the stadium. So I'm pretty excited to see what we got. I'm excited about it just because I get to have an opportunity to be with a bunch of old teammates, guys who I'm really still close to, and be able to talk to old coaches, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Now, your brother Dave signed as a free agent with your Cleveland Browns. How's that been so far? You had some OTAs.
Yeah, it's a dream come true, man. I mean, we're good friends, and so to have that experience together, you know, to be able to help him come along and coach him through this rookie year's tough. So yeah.
The next question is, did you have anything to do with him signing as a free agent in Cleveland?
You know, I'll just say I gave my head coach a call and said, if you can do anything to get one of them here, I'd appreciate it.
What are big brothers for, right?
Yeah, that's right.
And then your other brother, Joe, with Philadelphia, got drafted there. Three brothers possibly playing in the NFL at the same time. Gronkowski and Trufant, they're basically the only ones we know of.
Yeah, I've been pushing them, man. We're hoping to get it done.
All right, now the reason you're here is because you have a special thing going on here in a couple of weeks. The 14th and the 15th of June, the Cougar Care Foundation Youth Leadership Academy Day on June 14th. What is that, and what are you trying to accomplish?
Yeah. Well, the purpose of the, we called it Paragon, and it's a leadership and mentoring program. And what it's been designed for is basically to help teach the principles of success to high school age young men so that they can avoid the pitfalls that a lot of young men experience. So this is not an athletic program. It's not athlete specific. It's for anybody who wants to come and learn from people who have had success and not
like
just,
who?
Like Michael Orr is coming from the Ravens, the blind side.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have National Guard leaders there. We're going to have, there's going to be, for instance, one of my buddies who just graduated from medical school, you know, just basic things that he learned about his educational experience.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to be able to pass those things along. So really basic things that are going to translate into every opportunity in your life.
Now that's June 14th, young men ages, high school age basically.
High school ages, 14, 18 roughly.
Mm-hmm. And it's free.
Free.
At Tippinogas High School.
Free.
So they go to KrugerCare.org, correct? You see it
yep.
right there on your screen.
KrugerCare.org, yep.
And that's June 14th. And then you also have a third annual Kruger Care Golf Classic
yep.
at Thanksgiving Point. Still some spots available if they want to sign up, right?
Yeah.
$1,000 for foursome.
Yep. It's going to be pretty exciting. We got all sorts of stuff going on.
And you got Michael Orr coming to play golf as well
yeah.
and maybe some other NFLers.
Yep. We got Michael Orr, Torrey Smith, a lot of local guys, Haloti Ngata,
awesome.
Pitta. So it's going to be a great time.
Kruger Care. .org if you want to play in a golf tournament or if you want to send your kids to this Youth Leadership Academy Day. Paul, thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having
me. We got
me.
A couple of gifts for you. Ruby River, when you're back in town, you can go have a steak or a big old slab of chicken on us. Also, OGO, you got a travel bag. You do a lot of that. And I know you've picked up golf now. You're addicted to that. So they got plenty of golf bags and extreme bags for you. Paul Kruger, thanks, my man.
Thanks a lot.
That's a great opportunity to learn from Paul and other successful people. The Utah football program is also providing a great opportunity for kids kindergarten through eighth grade to participate in their youth camp.
Have fun. In fact, that's the number one rule.
We put on a couple camps every summer for the younger kids, kindergarten through eighth grade.
That's one of the things I think separates our camps from a lot of other college camps is that we do allow them to get into full pads and they get to do a lot of 11-on-11 scrimmaging.
We try to make that a great experience for them. We try to teach fundamentals.
We start with kids who are in 7, 8 years old, playing football for the first time, padding up.
You know, make sure that we're giving good instruction, the safe way to tackle.
If you learn how to tackle properly, you're going to eliminate most of the, you're never going to eliminate injuries completely in football. But if you learn how to tackle the right way, you're going to eliminate a lot of head and neck injuries that happen. Because when those happens, a lot of times it's because, the fundamentals weren't being followed. We have a lot of fun. Our best measure of how successful we were with camp is if the same campers that were with us last year can't wait to do it again this year.
A lot of these guys, this summer camp will be their first experience in a full padded football environment. We want to make sure that they leave here with a positive feeling about it and make sure that they're eager to continue on and play.
If you're looking for a good youth football camp, the Utah Utes have one right up here on campus, utahfootballcamp.com to register. We will have a link right here on ksl.com as well. For the Crimson Corner, I'm Mike Grant.
End around, gets a block from Wilson, and what a block it was.